Hello friends, hope you all are okay. My name is Rahul Mittal and today's video we will learn about camera feature in Excel. So let's start. Friends, I know maximum viewer not known about camera feature in Excel. If you know that, then it's good. But if you don't know about the camera feature, then this video is for you. Friends, first of all we will learn that how can we enable our camera feature in our Excel. So go to file, click option and click customize ribbon. Here what I am going to create my new tab, and inside I will create a group, and inside group I will put my camera feature. So click on new tab, select and rename it. I am renaming it as Rahul, and inside group I am giving that name as my tools. You can use an icon also. I am not using it currently, so just click OK. Now here you will select all commands and scroll down of C, and here you can see the camera. Click on camera. Here you can click add. Command need to be added custom groups. Okay, it is asking. So here just add, select my tool and click add, and you see camera feature will add. Now click OK. As you can see, new menu comes and inside my camera feature are showing. So first we will learn where we will use the camera feature. So camera feature is just to show you the final output result from your sheet. So I think it's clear that camera feature is used to show your final output result. So first we will create a final output result. As you can see, I have one small table. In this table I have a student name, class, math, English, Hindi, science and commerce subject, and here I have some student names having marks in each subject. Here I have give the totals and percentage achieved. So first we will represent, or we will provide a proper UI to show my final result. So friends, in next tab I have created one small UI where in this column, in this cell, I will provide the student name, here a class of particular student, and in this columns the marks achieved by that student which we provide here. Total marks of this student and percentage achieved. So first we will find this activity by using some formulas. So in this column we will use data validation to find the student name of these students, from Abhishek, Durga, Sneha till Yogesh. So select this cell, go to data and click on data validation, select data validation, in drop down select list. And here click on this icon, go to your original data, select the list of your students name, click here and click OK. Here you can see that list of students will come, like Abhishek, Durga till Vivek, not Vivek till Yogesh, as you can see. Now according whatever name, if I select Sneha, then Sneha, according to name, Sneha class and subjects marks of Sneha will be display. So for this we will use VLOOKUP. Friends, I already created one video of VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP. If you miss that video, then I will provide you the video link. You can go and watch it. So here we will use VLOOKUP. To select the cell, type equals to and write VLOOKUP. It is asking for VLOOKUP value. The my VLOOKUP value is my drop down value, comma, table array. Table array is my entire table, comma, column index. I have to show the class. So my column index number will be 2, because in second column I have defined all classes. So I will write 2, comma, 0. 0 is for exact match. Click enter. Here you can see Sneha in class 11th. If I check it in my data, Sneha is in class 11. Now the same activity or same VLOOKUP I am using in all the subjects. Now I will provide the total marks here. So I will use sum formula. So write equals to and write sum of all the subjects, close the bracket. The total is 350. Similarly, I will use the percentage for average formula, average of all the marks. So friends, as you can see, I have find my final output. What will I do? I will just change the name from Durga. As you can see, Durga is in class 10 and she got 55%. Similarly, if I select Saksham, Saksham got 88.2. If I select Anu, Anu got 91.4%. So this is the way my UI showing. Now here I am showing some color condition. So before writing color condition, what will I do? I will write small m here, and this m, when I write this m, I will just do small change, go to your font and select the font web dyeing. As you can see, a small human icon display here. So now what will I do? I will do one color coding. The color coding is that, as you can see in my data table, some students got blue color in percentage, some in orange, some in red, and some in green. Blue means percentage achieved, the range of percentage is in between 40 to 70 is in blue. Percentage in color in red shows the percentage less than 40. Orange shows percentage in between 70 to 90. And green shows above 90 and above 90. So the same color condition I am using here. So what will I do? I will select this cell percentage achieved and go to conditional formatting. Click new rule. Go to cell that contains. Here in cell value, what will I do? I will greater than, first I will select a green color. For green greater than equals to, here I am writing 90.00 greater than equals to. So here I will select green color. I am selecting bold as font style and green for color. Click OK. As you can see, Anu got green color. Similarly, first I will, we have done this. Similarly, you can see this icon is also in showing in black. So this, how can we do this? Select that icon, go to color condition, new rule, and here we will select use formula to determine which cell to format. Here we will select this cell. Here we will select this cell. And what we will do, we will remove the dollar icon. Greater than equals to 90.00. Go to format. Bold, and here I will select the same color. You can see here, you can see that icon is also green. Similarly, we will do for rest of the color condition. Now we will use orange color for range of 70 to 90. So I am doing the same in percentage, and similar color coding will do for this icon. Now everything is done. Here I will select one by one and check that the color condition. If I select Abhishek, then it is showing blue. If I select Durga, it is showing blue. If I select Suraj, it is showing red because he got less than 40% marks, so it is red. Similarly, if I select Sia, then she get 88.8% and it is in the orange color. If I select Anu, it is showing green because she got above 90%. Similarly, if I select Yogesh, then it is 90.2. And if I select Sachin, it is 73. So my color condition is same. Now what will we do? We will use camera feature. So what will I do? I will select the cell, go to your menu and select camera and paste whenever where you want. I just paste it here. And I will make this as a large icon as much as you want. You can reduce the size. Or you can make it center aligned like this. Similarly, once you select, go to style. And you can use any of the style you want. Like here I am doing circular 3D, not a 3D option. Here you can select whatever type of screen you want to see. Use your own. Okay, I'm selecting this. So this is my capture screenshot. Now what will we do? If I select change the name, here you can see a green color. Similarly, if I select this, it is showing red. If I select this, it is showing blue. So this is the way you can use your camera feature and you can display your output result as much as you want. So this is the way you can practice this. So friends, I hope this is an interesting video for you. If you think this is a useful video, then please like and share with your friends and also subscribe my channel. Till then, keep practicing and have a great day. Thank you.